What we know, what we have seen, is that America can change. That is the true genius of this nation. What we have already achieved gives us hope, the audacity to hope, for what we can and must achieve tomorrow.
I used to think the world was flat, really threw my head into the crowd. I felt I had used up my quota of yearning. Used to looking on the children at night, in the glow of their Donald Duck light, and frighten myself with the thought of my little ones burning. But oh, the tide is turning. Satellite buzzing through the endless night, exclusive to moonshots and world title fights. Jesus Christ, imagine what it must be earning. Who is the strongest? Who is the best? Who holds the aces, the east or the west? This is the crap our children are learning.
This union may never be perfect, but generation after generation has shown that it can always be perfected.
Now the satellite's confused, cause on Saturday night the airwaves were full of compassion and light, and his silicon heart warmed to the sight of a billion candles burning.
At this moment, in this election, we can come together and say, not this time. This time we want to talk about the crumbling schools that are stealing the future of black children and white children and Asian children and Hispanic children and Native American children. This time we want to reject the cynicism that tells us that these kids can't learn, that those kids who don't look like us are somebody else's problem. The children of America are not those kids, they are our kids, and we will not let them fall behind in the 21st century.
I'm not saying the battle is won, but on Saturday night, all those kids in the sun rested technology sword in the hands of the warlords.
This time, we want to talk about the shuttered mills that once provided a decent life for men and women of every race, and the homes for sale that once belonged to Americans from every religion, every region, every walk of life. This time, we want to talk about the fact that the real problem is not that someone who doesn't look like you might take your job, it's that the corporation you work for will ship it overseas for nothing more than a profit. We want to talk about the men and women of every color and creed who serve together and fight together and bleed together under the same proud flag. We want to talk about how to bring them home from a war that should have never been authorized and should have never been waged. It is not enough to give health care to the sick, or jobs to the jobless, or education to our children. But it is where we start. It is where our union grows stronger. And as so many generations have come to realize over the course of the 221 years since a band of patriots signed that document right here in Philadelphia, that is where perfection begins. Thank you very much, everyone.